Welcome to the Closed Environment Agriculture Greenhouse. Here we do aquaponics and hydroponics for production of both fish, in this case tilapia, and a variety of lettuces and plants that will be sent to the school's dining program at Seneca. Aquaponics is simply the culture of fish and plants together. Hydroponics is simply the raising of plants in aquatic media. Okay, so it has everything to do with where did the water come from? So this entire system is a recirculating system. So the water will enter the tilapia tanks, which is the fish that we currently raise. It's a warm water species of cichlid. And once it leaves the tank, it's gonna go behind underground here and into these filtration systems. Since we're recirculating or reusing the water, water quality is key. So what we're trying to do when we send it through these different filter systems is remove any uneaten food and any waste of any kind. So the major solids are caught by several screens. Once it leaves this sump area, it's gonna go into what looks like pool filters. Again, that's to capture fine particulate solids. But the real key and the real driver of this whole system is that blue filter right there. That's where we do our biological filtration. So that is taking out any toxic ammonia metabolites. The bacteria that colonize a bunch of little plastic balls inside this filter system help reduce that molecule so it's a non-toxic form. Then it water splits, it goes back to the fish and into the plants. So the nitrate that's already present in the water serves as a fertilizer. This is a raft system. So the plants are directly on top of the water, the roots growing directly down into the water, okay? And the nitrate that they receive from the fish waste, the broken down fish waste, serves as that fertilizer to help with growth. As they grow, we're pushing the rafts down. As they get bigger and bigger, we'll harvest at the end. And aquaculture students and horticulture students come together in this space. And they both learn about the animal culture side, so what does it take to keep the fish alive and happy, and what nutrients, what nutrition, and what life requirements have to be balanced with plants, okay? Plants like their water a little more acidic than fish do, and that has to do with nutrient availability. So we have to add some nutrients to this system, and we have to adjust the pH in this system versus what we have with the fish. So it's a little more complex to get the whole system functioning as a whole unit, okay? A couple other things that we do in here, we have an irrigation bed that we raise tomatoes in. The tomatoes are gonna grow up upwards of 9 to 10 feet, and then we start training their vines back down. So we have heirloom varieties of tomatoes that are going in today with horticulture students that are doing most of the planting. We have nutrient film technique, okay? All we're doing is running water across the root system through a PVC pipe, okay? The reason I like this system is because we can mirror image two different water sources. So this water source is actually aquaponic water, water that came from the fish and is flowing and recirculating through. And this system is hydroponic. So you have to do a little bit more addition on the hydroponic side than you do in the aquaponic side. So we have pH measurements that are happening live. We have temperature measurements that are happening both atmospherically, and we've started to add temp loggers to our water reservoirs. And we have a computer system that will notify us if there's an emergency. And the third thing that we have is a motorized and computerized shade cloth, okay? It uses a light meter, and we tell it if you have too much light basically to close, and if there's not enough light to close as well, because we want to keep the heat insulating in. So a little bit of automation that we are doing as far as training our students on systems that they would already have in a large scale production greenhouse. With this greenhouse, you're not going to see as much production as you would on the industrial side of aquaponics and hydroponics growth in large facilities that are producing many different types of plants. The reason is This is a model for education, okay? So we're trying to balance our students' educational experience with the actual production that we do. So one of the things that we end up doing here quite a bit are student projects. The projects that we'll do include anything from having students model what would happen if there was a nutrient deficiency in the water, to different types of lights that the industry might use, and how does that affect plant growth. So this is a research space as well as a production space. This particular tray is to start all of our seedlings. We start them in a material called rock wool. Holds moisture very well. And this media is what we're going to start the actual seeds in. They'll grow up to seedlings, then we'll transplant them into whatever system they're going into, the nutrient film technique system or the RAF system. In agriculture, anytime that you can control the outcome, you're at less mercy of the elements. That's the major thing. We want to be able to control production cycles. So here we can control light, we can control temperature, we can control the media in which they're growing in. Now the nice thing about this is an area like Morrisville, where we do not have necessarily the year-round access to a variety of different fruits and vegetables, we can give our students fresh fruits and vegetables that we produce on campus all year round. So these lettuces will do different cycles of harvesting, but generally we're going to harvest 6 to 8 weeks. So that's all year long we can provide fresh fruits and vegetables to our students.